Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to Jahan-e-Mann. And as I promised you that today we are bringing a very special workshop on spices of India. India is a country that is famous for its spices, for its culture, for its different religions. And it's said that India is a multicultural, a multifaceted country. India has lots of colors in it. And these colors can be seen in everything. These colors can be seen in the cultures. These colors can be seen in the environment. And these colors can be seen in the dresses of India and even in the spices of India. You know, the people in North India, they use different types of spices, while in South India, they use different types of spices. But this country is famous for the spices. I'm not talking about a spice while talking. I'm not talking about lip services. I'm talking about real spices in our food. Yes. So our food is so delicious because of these spices. And we have a very special guest who is an expert in home science, Mrs. Nishi Garg. Mrs. Nishi Garg has over 3 decades of experience in the field of home science. And she is the person who is an expert to describe the spices, its spices origin, the benefits, the usefulness, and everything she is going to tell us. Since this workshop is for the small children, so we are going to have it at initial level, at very beginning level. So this is for the beginners. If you are a beginner, you are most welcome. Come and join us. Thank you very much. Now, Nishi ma'am, over to you.
Hello, children. Good evening, everyone. Can you hear me, children?
Yes, they can hear you.
Okay, hello everyone. I'm very excited to know for everyone. How are you? Hello, children?
They are fine, but they cannot speak. They can just chat with you. And
so, children, I want to see you, but still, we don't have that provision. So, it's okay, children?
Yeah. Well and good.
What, children?
What are you saying, Maria? Say it again.
Yeah, well and good. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm very excited to tell you about the spices of India. So let's begin our class. Can I start the class, children?
Sure, ma'am.
Yes, of course you can start the class.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Children, so I'll start the class with the facts of India. Children, you must have heard about the East India Company. Children, you might have learned in your history class that the British created East India Company to enter India before they ruled us for 200 years. Now, the East India Company was created to carry on the trade of Indian spices. Britishers came to India for spices only.
Very true.
Mainly for black pepper, cumin, coriander, cinnamon, turmeric. This is a truth that they have come to India just for the spices. Now, I'll tell you the second fact. These spices have their own benefits, children. But some of them become even more beneficial when they are used together. For example, turmeric. We call it haldi. Turmeric has a substance called curcumin, which is also used to cure disease such as cancer, the deadly disease cancer. Now the body can only absorb curcumin if the turmeric is consumed together with pepper. Isn't it interesting, children? Just think that turmeric can be consumed with pepper, and that is a medicine for curing cancer. Did you get my point, children? And now the third fact that India is responsible for 70% of the global spice production. You know, children, the 70% of the spices are growing in our India only. We are the richest one for that. Look, the spices are 70% are, we are, all over the world is getting from India only. And now the third fact I'll tell you, which is very interesting, children. Salt. Of course, salt is a very different, it's, you can't call it an spice, but let me tell you that salt has been produced in India for over 5,000 years. Long time ago, Roman soldiers were paid their salary in salt. Just imagine that they were paid their salary for just with the salt only. And this is how the word celery was discovered. Soldiers were paid salt, and how we know that about the celery, this is the word has created, discovered. Any question, children, about the facts?
They will ask at the end.
Okay, okay. So now let's start your about the spices. Now I'm starting with the spices. Long. We call it, in Hindi we call it long. In English we call it clove. It has a very pungent smell, taste. Can you see long, children? Can they see? Can you see, children?
Let me give you a spotlight. Yes, now you show they can see.
See, this is called, we call it long in Hindi and clove in English. It has a very pungent smell and taste. Since ancient time, it has been known for its healing property. You know, this long is such, clove is so wonderful for toothaches. If anybody is having any toothache, you just keep one clove under your teeth and your pain will go away. Now I'll tell you something about this. This is also very common spice. We call it chakra phool in Hindi and star anise in English. See the beauty of this spice.
Yes. What is this
it
called?
It has a very sweety and fragrance, and it is used to enhance the smell of the food.
Nishi, what is this called?
This is called star anise in English, and in Hindi we call it chakra phool.
Okay.
And this is very common for when we are making, in Hindi we call it garam masala. So in all the spices we put this one also. This is a very important ingredient. So now the third one I'm showing you, this is called, in Hindi we call it badi ilaichi, or in English we call it large cardamom. This is called large cardamom. Also great taste and smell enhance. And we mainly use the seeds of it for sweets. This is also very good for our body to purify our blood. Now the fourth one I'm showing you, this is called, in Hindi we call it dalchini. In English we call it cinnamon. Can you see, children?
Yes, like yes, wood.
Ma'am. Yeah, it is just like a wood sticks. But this is cinnamon. It has a very sweet aroma, great for weight loss, for BP controlling, sugar level in our body. So it has a so many medicinal values in this cinnamon. So now the fifth one is, we call it dhania. Can you see? This is called dhania. In English, we call it coriander seeds. Look, this is called coriander seeds. This is for very good for digestion, improving metabolism, and commonly used in our Indian food. Now, I'm showing you.
It has cool effect. People say that all other spices have a hot effect, but coriander has cool effect.
Yes, it is very cool effect and very good for digestion.
Yeah.
Now, look, children, this is just like a small ring ball. You can see this is called Jaifal. In English, we call it nutmeg.
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg. It has a very nutty flavor and it is mainly used for making desserts and all. It has a very nice aroma. Nutmegs. You can see the nutmegs. Now I am showing you this one. These are just like a leaves. It looked like a dry leaves. Of course, these are dry leaves. This is called, in Hindi, we call it tejpatta. In English, we call it bay leaves. It also enhances the fragrance in our food and commonly used for Indian cuisine. Children, this is called, in Hindi, we call it zira. This is cumin seeds. This is the thing for which the Britishers came and they stood here for so many years. This is called cumin seeds, zira. Most common ingredient in Indian cooking, and it helps in boosting immunity and digestion. Now you can see, this is called, in Hindi we call it elaichi. In English we call it cardamom. It is known for its healing property, one of the most expensive spice. This is the most expensive spice. Also used in, for, you must have know that whenever your mama is making tea, it's a tea with elaichi and adrak. So this is a very, it has a very good aroma and good for mouth freshener and very good for this thing, for kidney, for stones also. If somebody is having kidney, having stones, one can use, boil 2-3 lychees, the cardamom, and you can drink water. That is a very good medicine for removing stone. Children, this is called sauf in Hindi. Fennel seeds. They are also very good for mouth freshener, very good for digestion, very good for stomach problems. It removes. So this also have very healthy properties for making good health. This is called, can you see? This is very small seeds. This is called ajwain in Hindi. In English, we call it carom seeds. Carom seeds, great for digestion and for stomach ache. If somebody is having stomach ache or any gastric problem, just take one spoon of this and the black salt, and you'll be fine in 2 or 3 minutes. So it's very good for stomach ache. Now I'm showing you methi. In Hindi we call it methi. In English we call it fenugreek. Fenugreek. Can you see, children?
Yes, ma'am.
It has a slight bitter taste, but it has a very high medicinal value. This is very good. If we'll boil this fenugreek seeds in water and wash our hair, the hair, it's a kind of a, no need of using shampoo. This is very good and good for stomach, good for diabetes. If diabetes patients are taking it early morning, they can cure their diabetes with this. So it has a medicinal value. Now I'm showing you kali mirch, the black pepper. Black pepper, it is used in food all over the world. Just imagine, this black pepper is used all over the world. All the main source of their spices, black pepper. Some in this thing, food item, they are using only black pepper, salt and black pepper, no other spice. They don't have in their country specially. So all over the world, they are using black pepper. This is what we are rich in. Our country is rich in producing this black pepper. Children, you must have heard about haldi. This haldi.
Yes, ma'am.
Turmeric, one of the most common spice, enhance color of the food. It is an antioxidant, natural painkiller, and used in curing diseases. And this is very good for skin also. You must have seen some beauty, this thing. They are making creams of it, turmeric. In ancient time, when we were not having any creams and foundations, people used to put this turmeric with some cream, and you can apply on your skin. Your skin will become very nice and soft like a baby. So this is called haldi. We call it turmeric, which is also has many this thing disease making. It makes disease away from us. Children, this is adrak, ginger. Ginger is a root. This is also a kind of a spice. I am carrying a fresh ginger, but for a spice, we make it dry, we have to make a powder of it, and then we are using in our food. Ginger is mainly a root and it has a very high medicinal value. If somebody is having cough, any lung problem, any stomach problem, any digestion problem, we are using this ginger. Ginger with honey, we are using it for many times. Your mama has also made it medicine for you also. Now, the last one I am showing you, this is called, children, it's a black seeds. This is called, in Hindi, we call it kalonji. And in English, we call it black cumin. This is black cumin. Great for digestion and used for making pickles. Mainly, we are putting this thing in pickle. But this is very good for joint pain. Kalonji is a very good for joint pain. This black cumin, people are making oil of it and giving for the joint pain, and it is very effective. So we are having most of the spices, they are just like a medicine. So we are very rich for this, children. You can see this box also. Look. There are soft, which I was telling you, funnel seeds, like this, mouth fresheners, are used. People are making it, and after dinner or the lunch, you can have it. It's a mouth freshener, and also it digests food quickly. So very good for this. And look, one more thing I'm showing you. This is kind of a hingoli, but it is written over here. It's a hingoli. Hing, we call it asafoetida. But all the ingredients like kali mirch, the black pepper, the clove, cumin seeds, fennel seeds, after all crushing it and making it the small balls of it, just to make a digestion like this. So these are the spices, children. Anything you want to know about it, children, more?
You know, children, there is a seed, whatever ma'am has shown you right now. So it is said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that there is a cure for every disease except death. What is that
yes.
seed? One seed is so useful and beneficial. Write in the chat box, let me see who is first. There is a seed that has cure for every disease except death. Oh, they all know it, it seems. Many of them have written correctly. Kalonji, black seed, black cumin. Yes.
Very nice.
Correct. Very good.
Very good, children.
Children, give a big round of applause to ma'am.
Nishi, yes, ma'am. Round of applause for everyone. Excellent, children. That means you are taking interest. Very good. Wonderful.
Okay, now we are going to have question answer sessions. If you have any questions, you are unmuted, you can ask the questions. Any questions on the spices? If you have, you ask, ma'am. Yes, Maria. Okay, now tell me one spice that is used in every food ma'am has not mentioned. In almost every food we use, in every vegetable, in every meat preparation.
Salt.
Spice I'm saying.
Salt.
No, black pepper ma'am has already informed. Turmeric also ma'am said. Clove also, ma'am said. Yes, Abdul Hadi is right. Ma'am has not mentioned hot red chilies. Isn't it? Nishi, please unmute yourself, Nishi. Unmute karlo. Aap mute ho chuke hain. So hot red chilies, who like it? Yes, Anul, chilies. Very good answer.
I would ask one question.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, as you told us that black pepper is also known as kali mirch, so could you please tell that why is it used for that? What are the benefits of that spices?
She's asking about black pepper, kali mirch. Nishi ma'am, please unmute. Yes.
Can they hear me?
Yes.
Children, black pepper, it is a very good, it is an antioxidant. and it is very good for many diseases. Kali mirch. It is for constipation, for coughing, for if the lungs are choked, if we are having cough in our this thing lungs, and sore throat. So this Kali mirch is excellent for all these things. It's a one of the best antioxidant.
Now you all must be thinking that which type of questions we are going to ask in the next Saturday quiz, where Yasir Bhai is going to be with us and he is going to ask the questions. So first thing you have to recognize, like ma'am has shown you each and every spice. So you should know the name in Hindi and English both. Both will be asked. Maybe we can show one spice and ask you what is the name in Hindi. English name will be given, or maybe Hindi name is given and you will be asked English name. So first of all, you have to learn the names of all the spices. Then secondly, we can ask about certain recipes, and then we can ask that which spice is mostly used in that. That also you have to keep in mind. And then which state is famous for which spice, because there are certain states that are famous for certain spices. So that fact also you have to remember. So these type of questions will be asked. Okay.